श्वेता, मैं रिकॉर्डिंग में स्टार्ट कर दे रहा हूँ अपना, है ना? यस मैम, स्टार्ट कीजिए।
या वेलकम टू ऑल आवर पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड स्पीकर्स एंड माय फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे इज 24 जुलाई 2020, द फिफ्थ डे ऑफ ऑनलाइन फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम ऑन इमर्जिंग ट्रेंड्स in data science and IoT. Our speakers, Dr. C. Azad and Dr. Ashok Kumar Mehta, are going to present on the topic of machine learning tools, techniques, and classification using support vector machine. Both sessions will continue on the same link, one after another. If anyone having any query, any kind of doubt, then they can drop their question on the chat box. Now it's a time to begin the program, so without taking much more time, we will start the program. But before that, I would like to call Dr. Arun Kumar Marandi on the screen for giving brief introduction about our today's speaker, first speaker, who is guest of honor, Dr. C. Azad. Please, Arun sir, come on the screen.
Thank you, Shweta ma'am. Dr. Chandrasekhar Azad is currently serving his duty from NIT Jamshedpur as a assistant professor, gold medalist. And MCA from Ranchi University, and the area of interest, data mining, intuition detection system, medical machine, machine learning, and pattern recognition. The subject interest, the database management, artificial intelligence, data mining, warehousing, machine learning, database security, and some programming concepts. Work experience, he has 2 years experience in the NIT Jamshedpur as a assistant professor, and the 3 years and an ad hoc faculty in NIT Jamshedpur. I welcome to you, sir, to present your knowledge and share your knowledge and brief description of the machine learning and technology and data mining also. Dr. Azad, please welcome and present your PPT.
So thank you, Marandi sir.
Thank you, sir.
So let me start the session. Okay, my screen is visible, Marandi sir? Please acknowledge me whether it is visible or not. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Your screen is visible and your voice is audible.
Okay, thank you. Very good evening, everyone present in this online FDP over the different part of the India and abroad. Machine learning tools and techniques for FDP at Arka Jain University, Jamshedpur. So my topic is machine learning here, tools and technique. So machine learning is an application of AI that provides system learning ability, system's ability to automatically learn from experiences. And if I discuss that particular learning here, the machine systems will get ability to automatically learn from experiences. And here, learning is what? Is the process of acquiring new understanding, knowledge, behavior, skills, values, attitude, etc. And that comes to the system automatically from experiences. Okay. So everybody today in our day-to-day life, most of you are experiencing different applications of machine learning. For example, if you have used Netflix, then you must know that it recommends you some movies or shows for watching based on what you have watched earlier. So machine learning is here used for this recommendation and select the data which matches your choice. So it uses the what? Your earlier data. Based on this, what Netflix will going to recommend some videos. Okay. Second example that already you're experiencing, that is what? That in the in Facebook, social media. Okay. So when you upload a photo on Facebook, it recognizes a person in that photo and suggests you mutual friends. Okay. So here ML is used for these predictions and it uses data like your friend list, photos available, and it makes predictions on that data. Okay. So these are the different examples that these are used. Okay. So another example that I would like to discuss, that is what? There are the some applications like, so how will you look when you get older? There are the some apps are available that it will going to show you how you will look when you get older. So such kinds of app using machine learning and image processing concept. So all these are the what example that help us to understand how machine learning is used, and ML is what somehow that is the subset of artificial intelligence. So in that particular presentation, I would like to discuss fundamental knowledge about the machine learning and different techniques there in machine learning that is used for the purposes of prediction. Okay. And then thereafter, I would like to discuss the some tools. Okay. And how these tools can be used in for the real life applications. That I would do. So my today's agenda is for discussion is like what is machine learning, okay, types of machine learning, how does machine learning works, real world applications, machine learning techniques, machine learning in security. That I would like to discuss one email spam detection using machine learning, how you can use machine learning techniques to develop a email spam detection system. Then thereafter, I would like to discuss the different machine learning tools, like how you can use machine learning concept in Weka, RapidMiner, Jupyter Notebook, and MATLAB. So, okay. So these things I am going to include in my today's presentation. Okay. So, what is machine learning? Okay. So before going to this, let's look about the what in the real world we are surrounded by humans and who can learn everything from their experiences with their learning capability. Okay. Computer or machine which work on our instruction. So, but that there is a question is arises, can a machine learn from experience or past data like human does? Like I want to give an example. Suppose that you have seen that if there is a small baby is there, if you try to pull his or her fingers towards to table lamp, okay, current is switched on. So first or second times the baby definitely will going to touch the table. Okay. So after experiencing the some heat or something like that, then thereafter, but when third or fourth time when trying to pull out his or her finger towards the table lamp, okay, so then what? He'll not going to touch the he or she will not going to touch the table lamp because there is something that is heat is there in the bulb. Okay, so that is experience. It means that that particular baby is child is learning from his or her own behavior. So can machine can experience such kinds of can machine can learn from such kinds of experiences? So the question is what? Yes. So machine here uses machine learning concept to learn from its past experiences. Okay. So then what is machine learning? So machine learning is what? It's a subset of artificial intelligence that is mainly concerned with allow a computer to learn from what? Past experiences. So machine learning giving a system to learn from its past experience without being explicitly programmed. Okay, so there is no if then else rule are fitted by the programmer. Simply what? Based on the what patterns in the data, machine learning algorithm gives a system that is automatically predict whenever we supply the some input instances. So in that term is coined by Arthur Samuels in 1959. Okay. And machine learning teaches computers to what does naturally comes to human, and that is learn from experience. Okay. So like here, what I told that machine learning is the concept to give intelligence to systems, machines. Okay. So here from, and that machines learn from what? It's past experiences. So past experiences are what? Are simple historical data that are known as training data. Okay. So based on the training data, machine learning algorithm builds a mathematical model, and that is later used for the purposes of prediction. And that is without being explicitly programmed by the programmer. Okay. So machine learning brings what? Concept of computer science and statistics together for creating such predictive models. Machine learning construct or uses the algorithm that learn from historical data. I already told that, like if I say that what if you, and the main task of each the machine learning system is to improve the performance over time. Okay, if suppose that overall knowledge is one something, and if it is not experiencing, it is not learning from its experiences, then what? After 365 it become one. But if learning by 0.01 rate, then what? After 365 days, it becomes 37.7. So what we can say that machine learning based system, it is learning from its experiences, previous data, historical data, then what? Over the time, its performance may be increasing. Okay. So machine learning versus traditional system. So in traditional programming systems like C, C++, or other what you provide, program and data, program and input, then what it will going to give output. But here in a machine learning based system, you have to provide what? Output, okay, and data, then what it will going to give you a program. And then further what you can use that particular program to predict something. So in earlier case, what? Program and data input are given, and traditional programming giving you what? Output, whereas in machine learning, the output will be some program, some model. Okay, and that particular further model is used for the purposes of predict future outcomes. Okay, so and then how does machine learning work? If machine learning learn from past experiences and over time it's improve its performance, then the question that is arises here: how does machine learning work? Okay. So a machine learning system learns from what? Historical data, builds the prediction model, then what? Predict output. So suppose we have a complex problem where we need to perform some prediction. So instead of writing code for it, we just feed the data to the some generic algorithm, and it will going to give us a prediction model. Okay, like you can see this in this figure shown here. Input data we have provided to the a generic machine learning algorithm, and it learns from the data. Here, learn from the data means it trying to find out the interesting patterns in the input data, and based on the found interesting pattern, a machine learning algorithm builds a logical model, and further that particular logical model takes the new data as the input, and that particular is used for the purposes of prediction. For example, I used two kind of data, thousands email of spam emails and thousand normal emails. Okay, and I used some machine learning techniques to build a spam detection logical model. So, and when I give a email input to the spam detection logical model, then what that particular model will going to tell us that whether that particular email is spam or not. Okay. So this way what we can use the machine learning model. Now these are the some structural description when what I told you that it machine learning algorithm based on the provided data it build a logical model. So what are the different how the machine learning models in how the logical models predicting something when new data is provided. So here maybe that particular logical model may contains the if-then rules or other things. So here I am considering that these are the input data provided to a generic machine learning algorithm. Then what might be, if it is a if-then rule-based algorithm is provided as a input along with the data here given, like age, spectral prescription, estimations, tear production rate, and the recommended lens will be either hard, known, or soft. Based on the generic algorithm, a rule-based algorithm, it will going to generate the some rules, and further that particular rules is used to predict what kind of lens is recommended to a particular user. Okay. Similarly, here you can see that rule-based machine learning algorithm, that these rules are generated from the given data set, that is the weather condition data, weather problem data set. The main output is whether to play or not, based on the some certain weather condition like outlook, temperature, humidity, and wind. So whenever I give that this data to machine learning algorithm, rule-based machine learning algorithm, it generates such and so rules. And further, these rules are used to predict whether to play or not, based on the certain condition of weather. Okay, similarly, that is, okay. Here earlier one is, all the data are categorical data, but here some data are categorical as well as some data are numerical. Okay. So that is it. Here the data provided to machine learning algorithms are mixed mode attribute. Okay. So this is the contact lens data set that I already discussed. Okay. Based on that particular data and generic machine learning algorithms that give us the following rules, and further these rules are used for the purposes of predictions. If I input such data, okay, for decision tree algorithm, then what? The generic decision tree algorithm will going to provide us a such kind of decision tree, and further that particular decision tree is used to predict recommended types of lens, whether it is a soft. Suppose the tear production rate is reduced, then what? No lens is recommended. Whereas tear production rate is normal and estimation is no, then our soft lens will be recommended to the some okay user. So this way what the decision tree based logical model will be represented. Now here suppose that that is for regression, one kind of problem is regression. Somehow what, like soft lens, hard lens, and soft non lens are recommended by the lens prediction system, but maybe in some cases continuous values are required. Like if I input the previous 3 months COVID-19 per day cases, new discovered patients and COVID-19 infected, then what previous history of the last 30 days or 20 days or 60 days we can use to predict next 10 days estimated COVID-19 infected patient. So there such kinds of problems may be solved by using the regression analysis. Okay, so here in regression analysis, the output will be continuous, whereas in classification of supervised learning algorithm, the output will be discrete, like yes, no, email or spam or not spam. But here, the output in regression function, that will be a numeric continuous value. So here, for that particular CPU performance predictor, that particular regression function is used to predict the value of the expected performance of a particular CPU. Okay, so the whatever I discussed the concept of machine learning here the most important thing is what, use features in the data, attribute of the data, and to create a predictive model. Okay, use features of the data and to create a predictive model that is used for the purposes of predictions. Okay, so here use features of the data and to that is used for the purposes of prediction. So here what, time to time, if you provide more data, then what, the performance of the system may be increased. Okay. So machine learning model finds what, natural patterns in the, and that generate insight that help you make better decision in prediction. So what, so I suppose that here you can see in this that particular picture, there are the two data is available. Suppose that just do nothing. Okay, this is just one data and it is impossible. This is another data, okay, raw data. So, but if I mix both the data, it become more meaningful. input. It means that what more data you provide and more then what it will going to give you the better answer. The better answer is what? Just do it. Nothing is impossible. So by simply what? Volume of data, if you are increasing, then what? Its performance increases. So what? Volume of data give insight into the data. And that is what? That make better decisions and predictions. So these are the some real world applications like in computational finance for credit scoring algorithm, trading algorithm, okay, real machine learning is used for image processing and computer vision, like for face recognition, for motion detection, object detection, computational biology like tumor detection, like cancer tumor detection, for such kind of purposes machine learning are used. And energy production for price and load forecasting. Automatic aerospace manufacturing for predictive maintenance, like Boeing company uses machine learning models for predictive maintenance. Natural language processing, such as like spam detection, text plagiarism detection, and for the purposes of sentiment analysis, natural language processing uses machine learning concepts. Okay. So these are the, I already told, in biology for tumor detection, in agriculture for predictive maintenance and forecasting, for image and video processing, or object detection, for energy, for load price forecasting and trading, the machine learning concepts are used in following areas like biology, agriculture, image and video processing, and energy. Okay. So these are the four basic terms in machine learning, which are interrelated to each other. Okay, so here AI, that is a superset, then ML, that is the subset of AI. Okay, but that is the superset for deep learning and neural network. Okay, so DL, deep learning, and the neural network. Okay, so AI is what? That is all about simulate the intelligence that tries to mimic human actions or decision making. Whereas the machine learning is what? That uses the statistical method that enables computer to learn from the data without being explicitly programmed. Whereas deep learning is what? It is a subfield of machine learning that uses multi-layer neural network in architecture. And the last one, that is the core of this, that artificial neural network, simply neural network, that uses the processing of brain as a basis to develop algorithm that can be used for further predictions. Okay, so these are the four terms, that these are the very popular in today in the different engineering applications. Now, so suppose that I want to develop a prediction model. Okay, then what? The following task has to be carried out for developing a model. Okay, so first is what? Gathering data. Second is data creation. Third, data wrangling. Fourth, data analysis and training the model. Fifth, test model. And the last one is the natural language processing. So in gathering the data, identify the different sources of data like files, databases, internet or mobile devices. Whereas in data preparations, what? That is mainly used for finding the correlations and general trends and outliers in the data. Data wrangling, that is used for the cleaning the data, outlier handling, noise handling, etc. purposes. Data analysis and training model, that is used for further developing the prediction model. Okay, based on the techniques you have selected. Okay, if you are selecting development and so on, association. Test model, that is fifth page of that particular. So in this what, in testing the model, in that particular page, we're going to test the effectiveness of the model, okay? Like accuracy of the model, okay? How much correctly it is giving the output, how much that is correct. And the last page, that is the natural language processing. That is what? Deploy the model in the real world so that what? The end user can interact with the system in their natural language, okay? Now, types of machine learning algorithm. The machine learning algorithms are mainly categorized into two categories, supervised learning and unsupervised learning. Whereas one technique is also there, that is called semi-supervised learning. That is the combination of the both the techniques, supervised learning as well as unsupervised learning. So in supervised learning, predictive model based on both input and output data. You always remember that in supervised learning, predictive model is based on the input as well as output data, whereas in unsupervised learning, predictive model is based on only the input data. So here in unsupervised learning, output of the data is not provided as a output. Okay, so clustering is unsupervised learning, whereas classification and regression are the supervised learning. Now, so in how supervised and unsupervised learning, I already discussed here, but I want to show you how these are different. So in case of the unsupervised learning model, unlabeled data is provided. Suppose that these are the attributes, D number of attributes are there. Okay, so in unsupervised learning, only x1, x11, x12, x1d are given input to the unsupervised learning algorithm. Okay, whereas in supervised learning algorithm, we have to provide xij and y. So you have to give the input x and y both, where y represent the output of that particular class. For example, here, suppose that you're developing a fruit classification system, then in case of the unsupervised learning algorithm, you have to only provide the length, width, and weight of the fruits to the unsupervised learning, in unsupervised learning. But in supervised learning, what? You have to provide the level of the fruit also. In supervised learning, along with the input, you have to provide the output also. So in supervised learning, input will be what? Length, width, weight, and level of the fruit. Whereas in case of the unsupervised learning, the input will be only length, width, and weight. Okay, so what is unsupervised learning? So unsupervised learning finds what? Hidden patterns or intrinsic structure in the data, and it is used to what? Draw the inferences from the data set. Okay, and that is very important here, without level responses, consisting of what? Input data without labeled responses. So here, clustering is the most common unsupervised learning technique, and it is used for exploratory data analysis to find the hidden patterns. Okay. So you can see here, in unsupervised learning, these are the given samples into the 2D plane. Okay. So whenever I give input these data to the clustering algorithm, then what you can see, the objects are categorized into different groups, okay? And whatever the groups there in a cluster are more similar as compared to the elements there in other groups, okay? So application of clustering are like gene sequence analysis, market research, and object recognition, okay? Now, what is supervised learning? So supervised learning what? It generate a predictive model based on the what? Known set of input data and known responses to the data. Okay, so classification technique what? Predict discrete responses. For example, like email is whether genuine or spam, whether a tumor is cancerous or benign. Okay, regression technique what? It predicts continuous responses. That I told you, if I give input last 30 days data, for a day data of COVID-19 detections in a regression model, then what it may be give you next 5 days prediction of estimated number of COVID cases, okay, 10 days, 30 days. Okay. So for such kinds of problem, you can use regression technique. Okay. Now, so these are the different classification algorithms. These are the clustering algorithms and these are the regression algorithms. So classification algorithms like decision tree, decision system, Navy bias, Gaussian Navy bias, Bernoulli Navy bias, multinomial Navy bias, k-nearest neighbor, support vector machine. Okay, so these are the different decision tree. These are the different supervised machine learning algorithm. Or another way, what we can say that these are the classification algorithms. Okay, so for all such algorithms, along with input attributes, you need to provide the output class level of each and every instance. Whereas in clustering algorithm, you need to provide only input, give the output of each and every instance. So different clustering algorithms are k-means clustering, k-medians clustering, k-mode clustering, fuzzy c-means, okay, DB scan, Gaussian mixture model, okay. Now, regression analysis. If you want the output in continuous value, then what you need to give the input attributes as well as output of that particular class. Okay, so for COVID-19 detections, you have to use the algorithms like linear regression, polynomial regression, Poisson regression, stepwise regression, and so many regression algorithms are also there, and even classification algorithms are there. So I only taken a few of the classification clustering and regression analysis algorithms. So till what we came to know that what is the machine learning, what are the different types of machine learning, okay, for machine learning classification problem, what kind of algorithm we can use, for cluster analysis, what kind of algorithm we can use, and regression analysis, what different types of algorithm we can use. Then the question arises, what is the workflow of supervised learning process? So here I already told you that in supervised learning algorithm, you have to provide the input as well as output. So here input is that is represented with the help of these following objects, and here output, that is the label of the each and every. So here you can see in the label data, there are three kinds of objects are there. Okay, so one is hexagon, another one is triangle, and third one is square. So I provided what? Label data to the machine learning algorithm, classification algorithm, what? It generates a prediction model. And whenever I supply some unlabeled data, okay? So here you can see in that particular test data, the level of data is not given. So that particular prediction model giving that what one object is square and another object is triangle. So that is the what basic workflow of supervised learning algorithm. Now, workflow of unsupervised learning. So here you can see the significant difference is what? In case of the supervised learning, we provided the label data, whereas in case of the animals, okay. So here I had given the data of different animals to the unsupervised learning algorithm, the clustering algorithm. Then you can see here, it generates a predictive model, a clustering model. Okay, then thereafter what? That's output are what? Data of animal dogs are separated and data of animal cats are separated. So the, one dog is the one cluster here and cat is the another cluster. So this way what that particular unsupervised learning algorithm find the intrinsic pattern in the unlabeled data and form the different clusters of the data. Machine learning can be also used in the security, okay, like that is used for the purposes of find insider threats, predict where bad neighborhoods are there, okay, that can be used for the purposes of detect malware in the encrypted traffic. We can also find out the suspicious user behavior. We can find out the spam emails, okay, and spam emails are unwanted and are access point for viruses and different kinds of malicious code or even malware. Okay. So here I'm going to discuss about the, what, how ML spam detection is developed using machine learning concept. So everybody knows that you have whenever you're going to open your email like in Gmail or Yahoo or Reddit mail, okay, so you can see that what there is a different folders are there, like your inbox, spam, etc. Okay, so in spam, what unwanted emails that are sent anonymously are stored. Okay, so most of the email messages are business in nature, and that is by phishing sites that are facilitating malware. Okay, so might be what somewhere somehow they do not have any effect on your privacy, but what it consumes a huge portion of inbox, and sometimes what it consumes, okay, dangerous in some scenario. Like you can see that that is the report of Kaspersky, proportion of the spam email in global mail traffic. That is the report of quarter one of 2019 and quarter two of 2019. So you can see that in month of the June, 56.91% of the email are spam. In May, 58.71% emails are spam, and so on. So almost more than 50% of the, around 50% of the emails are spam. So, and it consumes the resources. So that is the very important security aspect that is need to be taken care of. Okay, so here you can see there are the different types of emails like spam, politicized site by phishing scams, email spoofing, image spam. And these are the different techniques that is used for spamming, like open relay exploitation, hiding content, domain spoofing, poison filter, junk text, invalid words. Okay. Now, so earlier what? Earlier email spam detection technique, they use keywords-based detection technique. Like there is a word lottery in your email, then what? That will be classified as spam. Okay. But there are the several types of spam filters today available, like content-based filter. So in content-based filter, it reviews the content within the message to determine whether it is a spam or not. Header-based filter, simply it examines the header of the email and then it determines whether it is a spam or not. So in general, blacklist filter, okay, rule-based filter, some rules that is given by programmed by the users, okay, authentication filters, okay, challenge response filters, okay. So these are the different types of spam filters that are used for the whether that is used to determine whether some email is spam or not. So suppose that you, here I want to show how the content based spam filters is developed. Okay, so first step that is here carried out, that is the text processing. Okay, text pre-processing, then thereafter we need to, from email, we need to extract features from the emails. Then after a feature extraction, we will going to select a machine learning algorithm and generate a predictive model. And further what, we can test the effectiveness of the spam detection model, whatever we trained in the previous step, we can test this with the help of testing. Okay. Then further that part of spam detection. Pre-processing, what in this process of changing information to get meaningful content. Here, tokenization is the process of breaking a stream of text up into different words, phrases, symbols, or other meaningful elements. And these are big meaningful elements are called tokens. Okay. So the following processes is to be carried out in processing. Okay, like stemming, eliminate the noise, eliminating the noise. Then everything else. Okay. So what is stemming? That is simply inflected form of word is grouped together. So like there are the different words like group, groups, group. Then what? We would only consider all such words are grouped. So that is called stemming. Eliminating the noise means what? The unclear words in the emails create noise. So we have to eliminate such kinds of words from the emails. Everything else, what? That include what? Set all characters to lowercase. Okay. Evacuate numbers or simply convert the numbers to some meaningful symbols. Then expel the default stop words. Like stop words are here, like A and the, because these words are frequently used, but they do not carry useful information for classification. So we're going to what? Expel these stop default stop words. Okay, these are the general English. Okay, now after pre-processing, we're going to do what? Feature extraction from the data. Okay, so already I told you that in machine learning algorithm, the data will be input that contains the different attributes and output. So actually our data is what? Hello, you own lottery of $10,000, $10 lakh. So we need to convert, we need to extract the useful features from the, that particular method, and that will be represented in the matrix of form M process. Okay, and for each and every message, we have to label whether it is a spam or M. Okay, so features extraction method extracts feature from the text document and provide into a particular essential formats for the ML algorithm. So here are two techniques we will going to use. One is bag of words and another one is TFID and frequency and inverse document frequency. Okay, so let me discuss first the bag of words. Here we have the three text messages are there. First two are spam and the last third one is non-spam. So this movie is very scary and long. And the second is this movie is not scary and is slow. Third message that I received, that is this movie is spooky and good. So we need to design the vocabulary first. The very first step in bag of words model of feature extraction. In this what, you need to design the vocabulary. So the distinct word, there are 11 distinct word in that particular, this movie is very scary and long, slow, spooky and good. Okay. So what I extracted? the words from these three messages. Then thereafter what? In these 11 words, this movie is very scary and okay. I marked for one, here I given that if all attributes are binary, if the feature is available in the message one, then what? Put one, otherwise put zero. So you can see here in review one, not is not there, so I used a zero. In review two, scary is not there, so I used zero. In review two, each came twice, so I have taken two. In review three, here I considered stop words also. Okay. In review three, not and slow are not there, so I considered here. Okay, so here these are the simple text cleaning technique that can be used for system like ignoring cases, ignoring punctuations, fixing misspelled word, etc. Okay, so after creating vocabulary, then thereafter what? Create the document vector, and then thereafter label. Okay, on that particular matrix form, and along with the output data, label data, you can give input to the some machine learning algorithm. Okay, now. This is the second method of feature extraction from text, that is the TF-IDF. Okay, so in the in this, we're going to find out the how frequently a term T appears in a document T. So first we need to compute the term frequency TF, term T in document T, that is equal to what? Number of times term T appears in document T divided by what number of terms in the total document. Okay, then thereafter what we need to compute the IDF, that is the inverse document frequency. So let's take one example. That is the this is the one spam message. This movie is not scary and is slow. So total in all the three review, total number of words are 11. Okay. So number of words in review two are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total number of words there in the review two is 8. So TF value of this is equal to what number of times? Okay. I need to find out what term frequency of word. This so therefore okay, so how to compute this term frequency of word this, that is equal to what number of times this appears in a review two, okay, divided by total number of words in the review two. Okay, 7 for slow term frequency is 0, for end in review two term frequency is 1/8, whereas for good term frequency of good in review 3, that is equal to 1/6. So this way what? You need to compute the term frequency of every word in every document. Now, after computing the term frequency, what to do? We need to compute the inverse document frequency. And that measures the how the IDF is one measure of how important a term. Okay, so that can be computed using that particular formula, log of number of documents divided by number of documents with terms. Okay. So measuring the what importance of a particular term. So here you can see I want to compute the IDF of what this. So that is equal to what log number of documents, already there are three, review one, review two, and review three. Okay, divided by number of document that contains what this. So this is there. You can see this is available in this in all the review. Okay, so term frequency, inverse document frequency, that is equal to what? 3/3. 3 is the number of documents, total 3 reviews are available there. And 3 here, the denominator, that determines what number of documents containing the word this. So that is equal to what? Log 1. So that is equal to 0. Similar way, what? You have to compute the IDF of each and every words. Okay. So these are the IDF of all the words in review wise. So these are the okay IDF. Okay, you can compute. Then thereafter what? You need to compute the TF-IDF value. So TF-IDF is what? Basically, TF into IDF. Okay, for each and every words. TF, TD into IDF, T. Okay, so you can see here, TF of this in review 2, that is equal to 1/8, that already we computed here, that is equal to 1/8, whereas IDF of word is, okay, in the all the document, that is equal to 0. So PF of this in review 2 into the IDF of this in all the documents, that is equal to 0. So PF IDF value of this in review 2, that is equal to 0. So this way what you need to compute the TF IDF value of each and every term. Okay. So here I computed the TF IDF value of each and every review. You can see this column represents the TF IDF value of each and every words there in the review 1, whereas in second TF IDF that shows the TF IDF value of review 2. Here it is showing the TF IDF value of review 3. So I already told you that the first two reviews are spam and the last one is non-spam ham message. So further, you have to give that particular three attribute as an input and the class level of each and every instance to the classification algorithm. Further, it will going to generate a classification model. So this way, what you can use the text data for developing a prediction system. Okay. So I'm going to show you one classifier. Okay, so here that is the very popular classifier, non-parametric classifier, that is Navy Bayes classifier. Okay, so that is based on the concept of prior probability, likelihood, and the marginal likelihood. So prior probability is the proportion of dependent variable that is the target or class level in the data set, whereas likelihood is the what probability of particular classification a given observation in presence of other variable. Okay, marginal likelihood is a proportion of the independent variable in the data set. So for you have to carry out these three steps, okay, for classification using Navy Bayes. So convert the data set into frequency table, okay, then create the likelihood table, then use Navy Bayes equation to calculate the posterior probability for each class. Suppose that your data set contains two class like spam and non-spam, or whether to play or not, to, okay, spam or not spam, then what? You need to compute the posterior probability for each class, and then what? Based on the calculated posterior probability, you can decide whether some input instance is spam or not. So that will be determined by using what? The class with the highest posterior probability is the outcome of the prediction. Suppose that for class spam, the posterior probability is 0.5. 0.6, and for non-spam, the posterior probability will be 0.4. So in such scenario, what? The posterior probability of spam is 0.6. So that particular email message will be classified as predicted as spam. So this is the example. Suppose that our data set contains following data. So you need to first convert to the contingency table. Okay. So you can see these are the three distinct values there in the weather data, overcast, rainy, and sunny. Okay, and there are the two classes are there, yes and no. So corresponding value you have to find overcast here for 0 times no, okay, and 4 times yes, rainy 3 no and 2 yes, sunny 2 no and 3. Based on this contingency table, you need to compute the likelihood. So among the 14 samples, there are the 14 samples are there. So overcast value, that is 4 by 14, for rainy 3 by 14, for yes 2 by 14 and so on. So this way what you can convert contingency table to likelihood table. So and further you can use that particular Navy Bayes formula, okay, to predict the class level of a particular input instance. Okay, so let me show you that here that particular input data is what? Feature 1, feature 2, weather and wind, and weather to play or not. And algorithm that you are using, that is Navy Bayes, okay? And we need to predict the outcome of that particular input instance when wind is moderate and weather is sunny, okay? Based on the Navy Bayes model trained using that particular given data. So you can see here calculations are given. So first of all, what we need to find out the posterior probability for class equal to yes for the given input instance. And then what we need to compute the posterior probability of class equal to no for the given input instance. So you can see here for class yes, posterior probability for class yes is equal to 0.098, whereas posterior probability for class is equal to no, that is equal to 0.0036. So that is clearly what the probability of 0.0098 is greater than the 0.0036. So class level that is predicted by the Navi Bayes algorithm in this is yes. So thus our prediction system is what? Given the data point H class, yes, meaning that in that according to the predictions, we can play if the wind is moderate and weather is sunny. So this way what you can use the Navi Bayes algorithm. Similarly, what you can use other classifiers like KNN, SBM, Perceptron and all kind of supervised machine learning algorithms. Now, after generating the model, how can I test the effectiveness of the proposed prediction system? So for that particular purpose, we can use the different performance measures for checking the effectiveness of the prediction model. So for this purpose, what performance evaluation we're going to use the confusion matrix. Okay. So in confusion matrix, that is the what visualization of the, it allows the visualization of the performance of an algorithm. So here one side you can see actual classes are given and the column side you can see predicted classes are given. So that is for the two binary classification. So here only two classes are there, positive and negative. Okay. So when actually that is positive and that is predicted as positive, that is called as true positive. And the ratio of actual positive or predicted negative, that is called false negative. Actual negative and number of actual negative and predicted positive, that is false positive. And if it actual negative and negative, predicted negative, that is true negative. So the formula for the sensitive will be what? True positive versus true positive plus false negative. The specificity will be true negative by true negative plus false positive. Precision, that is true positive plus false positive. Okay, and negative predictive value NPV, that is equal to what? True negative upon true negative plus false negative. And the accuracy will be computed based on the what? True positive plus true negative divided by the TP plus TN plus FP plus FN. Based on this, we can determine the performance of a particular classification algorithm. So, suppose that total 45 instance, okay, 2P, TN 30, FN 20, and FP. Suppose that is the case of the email spam detection system. Okay, so by using this value, you can see sensitivity is equal to what? TP by TP plus FN, so that is equal to 69.23% of the emails which are spam along all the spam emails. Okay. Now, specificity, that is equal to what? TN divided by TN plus FP. So that's value is equal to what? 85.71. And here, based on that particular number, we can say that 85.71% of non-spam emails are actually classified and excluded from the all spam emails. Precision, that is equal to what? TP divided by TP plus FP. So that is equal to 90%. So the 90% of the samples are classified as spam, are actually spam. Similarly, accuracy, that is equal to what? TP by TP plus TN divided by all. So that is equal to what? 75%. So we can say that 75% of examples are correctly classified by the classifier. So this way, what you can by using the different performance measure, you can effectively calculate the performance of a prediction model. Sensitivity, specificity, precision, recall, accuracy, there and so many performance parameters are there. So I shown you here only few 4 to 5 performance measures. Okay. Now, next is popular machine learning software tools. Okay. So these are the some popular machine learning tools like scikit-learn. Okay, you can use in Linux, Mac OS for classification, regression, clustering. PyTorch, you can use in Linux, Mac, Windows. That use NN model, Opti model, module, AutoGrade module. TensorFlow OS like Linux, Mac, Windows, Python. Okay. Weka, you can use in Linux, Mac, Windows. Okay. For classification, regression, clustering, visualization, etc. And all these are free. Okay, so you can use NIME, CoLab, okay, Apache Maud, okay, XSRNets, RapidMiner. These are the different popular machine learning tools that are widely used by the different organizations for purposes of even for academic purpose, for research purpose. Even some companies are also using such products for generating machine learning based models. Okay. Now, let me discuss what some tools, how you can effectively use such tools for machine learning. So here, first tool that I would like to discuss, that is Weka. So first of all, what install the Weka, okay, from Weka website, okay, then open Weka, okay. So here I install, that is Weka 3.8, okay. Then go to the Explorer, then window will open. Then thereafter what, you need to import the dataset to Weka. So for importing the dataset, you need to click on open file, okay. Then select the dataset from the desired location of your computer, okay. Then click on open. So here you can see here XAPI EDU data is opened, okay. That contains 17 attributes and total number of classes are there are 2, M and F, okay. So M total 305 and F 175, and total number of instances in that particular data set, that is equal to 480, and attributes are 17, okay. So this way, after importing the data set, first step is what? In Weka, you need to import the data set, okay. Then what? You need to classify the data. So for this purpose, you have to choose appropriate classifier, okay. Based on this, you can generate the classification model. So here, I expand that particular classifier, okay. So these are the different kinds of classifiers, like Bayesian, functions, lazy, meta, rules, tree-based. So here, suppose that I selected decision tree-based classifier, that is J48 here, okay. So I selected what, decision tree classifier, okay. Then after, first import the data, then choose appropriate classifier. Third step is what? Select the appropriate testing scheme, okay. So either you can test with using same training data, you can test using supplied test data set, or simply you can use K-fold cross validation techniques, or even the fourth that is used, you can use percentage split, like 60% data you can use as a training and for remaining 40% are used for the purposes of testing. After selecting the test option, you need to click on the start, okay. So whenever we're going to click on the start, it will going to generate a machine learning model, and then it will give you the classification result of supplied test option. As per the supplied test option, suppose that you opted a cross validation, K-fold cross validation like 10. Okay. So here, then thereafter what you can see, it will going to show you the correctly classified instances, incorrectly classified instances, and so on. So this way what, you can measure the performance of the particular machine learning algorithm or whatever the prediction model you have generated using the some training data. Okay. So this way what you can, so this is the model generated using the Weka tool. Okay. Now, second tool that I want to discuss, that is the Jupyter Notebook. Okay. So you open the Jupyter Notebook. You first you have to install the Jupyter Notebook, or you can install the Anaconda IDE. First open the Anaconda, then what? Go to new. Okay. Okay. Then create this, okay, Python 3, okay. Then thereafter what, after new, you have to enter the following details. So here you can see here, load the library first and click right mark here, okay. So here, load digits, so digit data set will be loaded here. Then thereafter what to do, you need to, divide the data set into train set and test set. Train test is splitting, okay. So X train, X test, okay, Y train. So X train and the associated level is Y train, X test, that is testing data set, and Y test is the associated class level of testing data set that is used for further performance evaluation, okay. Now, then thereafter what, we need to train the model. So here I use what, logistic regression model, okay. Okay, so here using logistic regression, and the output with 95.92%, then support vector classifier that you So here it gives accuracy of 97%. So this is what you can use in Jupyter Notebook. MATLAB, how can you use the concept in MATLAB? Open MATLAB in your system. Then thereafter what? Load the data sets by using fopen data.csv. Here the data is kept in data.csv. Then after reading the data, okay, you have to divide the data set into x data and y data. Okay, that is the training data set. Okay, then thereafter you have to load the data set. Then you can train the classifier. That is what I trained here. KNN algorithm, that is k nearest neighbor. I used k nearest neighbor. So fit c KNN. Okay, I had given the input instance here x that is the inputs and y is the output. So I had given, and here for that purposes KNN algorithm used Euclidean distance. You can use Manhattan distance, cosine similarity, and so many distances are there. Okay, 4 minutes is there. Okay, now so this way what you can use. So then thereafter what? After training the model, so I am giving the input, following input as a testing. So you can see that what? It is giving output as a setosa. Okay. So this way what? I computed the outcome of that particular given input instance. Okay. So this way what? You can use the MATLAB for machine learning algorithms. Okay. So in that particular machine learning tools and techniques, I discussed about the concept of machine learning, types of machine learning, workflow of machine learning. Okay, machine learning tools like Weka, Jupyter Notebook, and MATLAB, how can you use to construct the, you can develop the machine learning algorithms. And also I discussed what, how you can extract the useful features from a text data. Okay, so my part is over. So if any question, then that is welcome. So I'm waiting
thank
for
you,
the question.
Thank you, sir. Ajaz sir, thank you.
Yes, sir. If any question, then please.
Yeah. We collect question from YouTube link.
Okay.
Shweta ma'am, kindly collect a question from YouTube link. Sir, you stopping the presentation, sir.
Okay.
We discuss about some questions.
Okay. Yeah, let me stop this presentation.
And kindly share your PPT, sir.
Okay, sir.
You send me and I circulate the PPT from participants.
Okay, sir, I will share.
Yeah. Sir, can you explain NN technology, how many hidden nodes are required?
Actually, what that is not fixed. Okay, that will be depends on the what different training and testing. Okay, based on the what after training, multiple training, we can decide how many hidden layers will be giving the what best results. Based on the multiple trainings, we can decide the number of hidden layers.
Yeah. So, some more question from the YouTube. Sir, which technique is better in machine learning?
Actually, what technique is good for? That will depend on the type of data. Okay. So,
yeah.
Type of data that will also depend. So, we cannot say like. You cannot say that particular technique is good. Okay, so you have to train for the different algorithms. Like suppose that your data output is for continuous output, you want continuous output, then you have to take regression techniques. Okay, suppose that your data set is having discrete output, then you have to select the supervised learning algorithm. And if some data sets whose class level are not known, then what you have to select unsupervised learning algorithm, like clustering algorithm. Okay. But in data sets, some data sets are labeled and some data sets are not labeled. In such scenario, we can use semi-supervised learning.
Okay.
These are two-day semi-supervised algorithms are very popular also.
One more question, Ajak sir.
How to detect
the spam from color image?
Okay.
For future extension.
Okay. First of all, apply the different image filters. So, for image processing, today deep learning techniques are used. So you need not to extract features from data images.
Hello. The participants, some network issue. Ajaz sir, some network issue. Your voice is not coming. Kindly repeat your answer, sir.
Okay. Now it is audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible.
For image processing based, first you need to extract the feature by using the different image filters like HOG, histogram. Okay, there are so many image filters are there. After extracting the features from the images, then thereafter what you can give input such in extracted features to the machine learning algorithm, and further that is used for the purposes of prediction. Okay, but today what deep learning techniques are more popular for image based prediction system. Okay, deep learning based system here. In deep learning based system, you need not to extract the features from the images. It automatically extract the features from the image data. Then further, the automatically it is generating the prediction model based on the images. And then further, you can use such models for prediction purposes.
One more question, sir. Which tool is better to detect emotion classification in speech?
Okay, you can that will depends on like deep learning techniques currently very popular, but the thing is that deep learning the systems are too costly for beginners. They can extract the features from speech you told that na
emotion. Yes sir.
Okay, so like different filters you can apply like DCT, DWT. And extract the features, and further you can beginners you can test the whatever features you extracted using DCT, WT and okay, and then further you can use any kind of supervised algorithm for unsupervised algorithm for emotion detection.
Okay thank you Ajak sir, thank you. Very wonderful presentation given the your knowledge very deep in your machine learning and data, big data analysis and analytics. Your time is very valuable for this FTP. I thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Anything you? Okay. Our next speaker is available, Professor Ajak sir. Any live example? Ajak sir, you online? Ajak sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can you one live project and live tool? We can analyze all these things.
Okay, you can use Python or Python. You can develop some algorithms. Okay, and analyze the data.
Any idea about visualization, sir? Data visualization.
Like Tableau, you can use Tableau. Okay, Tableau is used for purposes of data visualization. And what data visualization techniques are very much popular to detect the outliers and trends in the data, or even data visualization techniques are used for the forecasting. Okay, so for that purposes you can use a tool like Tableau. Even Python you can also use, but Tableau is very popular.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you, Ajak sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Now. Now, the first session is offered. All the participants, we share all the PPTs and the video. He is Associate Professor, Department of Computer Application, NIT Jamshedpur. And his PhD degree received from Jadavpur University, Kolkata. The topic is Reliability Evaluation of an Interconnected Power System in Degraded Environments. And he's received her M.Tech in Power System, RIT Jamshedpur, Ranchi University. Sir is doing works in learning fuzzy techniques and data analysis and computer organization. Sir, I welcome you. Sir, Mehta sir, I welcome you. Please present your topic. Sir, topic is classification of vector support machine. And this is the hands-on session, live, Mehta sir, live presenting and live demo, how to configure in the Colab, Google Colab Labs, and some data are I share it in your mail ID, open data sets. Kindly those participants who have interested, kindly follow the steps of the Dr. Mehta sir. So I would like to invite Mehta. सर नहीं नहीं अब उसको मत चाहिए ना सर उसको कट कर दीजिए एंटायर जो आप किया ना नीचे पीपीटी को आप उसको कट डाउन कर दीजिए हाँ क्रॉस करो एंड अब अपना पीपीटी पे क्लिक कीजिए अब पीपीटी पे क्लिक कीजिए सीधा डायरेक्ट हाँ अब प्रेजेंट हो रहा है सर दिख रहा है पीपीटी दिख रहा है आपका फुल स्क्रीन कीजिए फिर उसके बाद आप जैसे ही गूगल क्लास में जाइएगा ना सर लिंक में क्लिक कीजिएगा जैसे आपके स्क्रीन में जो चीज डिस्प्ले होगा वो हम लोग को भी डिस्प्ले होगा ठीक है सर ओके सर प्रेजेंट कीजिए मेहता सर योर audio is disabled. Sir, unmute your unmute yes sir. Sir, again you unmute, sir. Sir, camera को फिर से आप अनप्लग करके फिर से लगाइए सर हो जाएगा इसको इसको नहीं सर फिर से अपना यूएसबी कनेक्शन देखिए सर जहां पे माइक लगा होगा For the technical issue, sir is coming just now. Just wait for him. Some technical issue, sir is coming now. Dear participant, be patient. Sir is coming now. Something is wrong in the connectivity. So, yes, sir. Hello, Mehta, sir. Yes, sir. Check your connection, sir. Mehta, sir. Kindly check your connection. Yes, sir, your PPT, just click on the PPT, sir, PPT, yes. Yeah, it's come on. Sir, usme click nahi karna, just PPT pe jaiye, aa jayega aapka, PPT pe jaiye, sir, seedha direct PPT pe. हाँ बस उस पर क्लिक कीजिए. हाँ बस आ जाएगा सर. इसमें नहीं आना, फिर उसे पीपीटी में ही रहना है सर. अपना पीपीटी में ही रहिए सर.
सर प्लीज क्लिक ऑन द लिंक फर्स्ट. या क्लिक. या देन क्लिक ऑन द जॉइन नाउ.
देन जॉइन नाउ क्लिक कीजिए सर. जॉइन नाउ. हाँ यू विजिबल सर. यू विजिबल. ज्वाइन नाउ. ज्वाइन नाउ. प्रेजेंट नहीं. प्रेजेंट नहीं सर.
नो सर. सर डोंट क्लिक ऑन द प्रेजेंट.
ज्वाइन नाउ पे जाना है सर. ज्वाइन नाउ.
सर प्लीज गो ऑन द मेन सर.
ओके ओके. आई फर्स्ट टाइम ये ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं गूगल मीट पे. दैट्स वेयर दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम.
यही दिक्कत है. अरुण सर.
मेहता सर. मेहता सर अपना आवाज बोलिए सर.
नहीं आएगी सर उनकी आवाज. अरुण सर आप प्लीज उनको एक बार कॉल कीजिए. अरुण सर.
ओके 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 ओके. हाँ मैं कॉल कर रहा हूँ.
उनको एक बार बोलिए कि he will click on the join now.
सर ज्वाइन नाउ पे प्रेजेंट में नहीं जाना था, ज्वाइन नाउ पे क्लिक करते हैं. हाँ 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 ज्वाइन नाउ पे क्लिक करना है. एग्जिट होइए, एग्जिट होइए, फिर से आप क्लिक होके फिर आइए. हेलो सर, हेलो यस सर, यस सर ज्वाइन यू. स्पीकर स्पीकर अपना ऑन कीजिए सर. आवाज आ रहा है सर.
या
हाँ आ रहा है सर, अब आ रहा है, अब आ रहा है. अब प्रेजेंट कीजिए सर. साइड में नीचे पे प्रेजेंट प्रेजेंट नाउ का साइन है, उस पे जाइए, उस पे फिर एंटायर पे क्लिक कीजिएगा, हो जाएगा सर.
हाँ
स्क्रीन पे जाइए सर, स्क्रीन के नीचे में लिखिए
प्रेजेंट नाउ.
हाँ हाँ हाँ
राइट साइड में नीचे सर. हाँ
एंटायर स्क्रीन.
फिर शेयर को क्लिक कीजिए बीच में, एंड देन शेयर आ जाएगा, शेयर पे क्लिक कीजिए.
शेयर तो आया.
यस सर, अब पीपीटी पे जाइए सर. पीपीटी नीचे पे जो है, पीपीटी पे आप क्लिक कीजिए. यस सर, हाँ अब आ गया सर. यस सर, इट्स नाउ ओके सर.
गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी. तो आई शैल डिस्कस सपोर्ट वेक्टर मशीन नाउ. एसवीएम यूजेस सुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग एल्गोरिदम. Supervised means in the presence of supervisor or teacher, and SVMs are used both for classification and regression analysis. Now, the basic principle of SVM is SVM defines a hyperplane or a set of hyperplanes in a higher dimensional space. Now, for two class data, SVM selects a set of input data to predict for each given input which of the two possible classes the output belongs. And we shall divide the two class data into separator and nonlinear transformation using kernel. Now, separable data. So now, consider a two class linearly separable classification problem. Now, it is linearly separable. So the decision boundary should be as far away from the data of both classes as possible. And we should maximize the margin M and distance between the origin and the line W dot X equal to K is K by norm of W. So here our data set is X1, X2 up to Xn, and let Yi here minus 1 and 1 be the class level of Xi. The decision boundary should classify all points correctly by using this equation yi w dot xi plus b minus 1 greater or equal and circles. And on the boundary, say it is encircled. And here margin more
then it is better classified. Say, you know that in real life also, if in your house there is a, say, guava tree, then nearby children pluck it. So here, same principle. So margin more. Margin is given by 2 by norm of W. Say, it is the upper line is W dot X plus B equal to 1. The distance from origin is will be, if you move the B to the right side, so it will be 1 minus B. And lower boundary W dot X plus B equal to minus 1. Now move B to right side, so minus 1 minus B. And so the margin distance will be, so simply subtract it. 1 minus B minus minus 1 minus B. So plus B, you will get numerator 2. Denominator is norm of W. So this is the separable data. I W dot Xi plus B minus 1, data equal to 0 for I 1 to N. Here I have not shown the mathematical derivation because all will not be interested in that. Nobody they work in this area, then you ask your coordinator, Dr. Marandi, he will give you the in detail the mathematical derivation. So now, non-separable data. Here some samples have crossed it. Okay, few samples. And no, called error. This is psi I in classification. So now, again the equation will change. And now the equation has become minimized 0.5 C summation I 1 to N psi I. So here C is trade-off parameter between error and margin. So we take moderate value of C. If you take higher value of C, then there will be overfitting. Now, see the figure left side, it is non-linearly separable. So, we go to higher dimension and then there it is linearly separable. The right side feature space is of higher dimension than the input space in practice. And PIDI transform Xi to a higher dimensional space, input space, the space, the point Xi are located, and feature space, the space of higher after transformation. It does not need to represent the space explicitly, simply by defining a kernel function. Computation in the feature space can be costly because it is high dimensional. The feature space is typically infinite dimensional. And the kernel tree comes to rescue in the dual SVM optimization problem. The data points only appear as dot product. As long as we can calculate the dot product in the feature space, we do not need the mapping explicitly. The kernel function plays the role of the dot product in the feature space. Here the kernel function K defined by kx1x, phi xi dot phi xj. The linear classifier relies on dot product between vectors kxi phi xj equal to xi dot xj. The use of kernel function to avoid carrying out phi dot explicitly is known as the kernel trick. Now these are the term commonly used kernels: polynomial, Gaussian radial basis, neural net. Now, applications of SVM. They are used in text and hypertext categorization, image classification, bioinformatics, protein classification, cancer classification, handwritten character recognition. These are the some of the applications of SVM. Now you have studied neural networks, so comparison with the neural networks. In neural networks, you have hidden layers mapped to lower dimensional spaces. And in SVM, kernel maps to a very high dimensional space. In neural networks, such space has multiple local minima. And in SVM, such space has a unique minimum. Neural network training is expensive, and here in SVM, training is extremely efficient. In neural network classification, extremely efficient, and in SVM also classification is extremely efficient. In SVM, kernel and cost are two parameters to select. And both have very good accuracy in typical domains, and but SVM is robust. So now for classification, we performance is described using confusion matrix. Okay, so I am simply give him some description. Let there are 500 samples, out of which 250 are of class 0 and 250 of class 1. Then after training through machine learning, say the predicted class 0 is 230. And so wrong will be, means class 1 will be 20. Similarly, here the for class 1, predicted is 220 and wrong predicted 30. So now we have considered 0 is negative and 1 is positive. So predicted 0 class. Say here we have seen that it is 230 and wrong predicted 20, false positive. So, and for class 1, actually 250 given, and so true predicted is 220, and the false one is 30, false one is 30. So, here the diagonal term TN and TP, 230 and 220 are the correct predicted. So accuracy is given by TP plus TN divided by all the terms TN plus TP plus FP plus FN. Similarly, precision is given by TP, by TP plus FP, means all positive, true positive by positive plus false positive. And recall by TP plus FN. TP plus N is the horizontal. So now this is all about SVM. Now we shall take one and see. Now open Google Colab.
Yes sir, yes sir. We are opening.
Opening, okay. So now click on new notebook. Click new notebook.
Dear participant, please open the step-by-step Google Colab. That is very informative.
All have opened this screen.
Yes, sir. We changed the name of file.
Yeah. Support vector classifier.
Okay, sir. We change it.
Now, click this rectangle. It's connecting. Now, under files, there is rectangle showing arrow. Click that one. And load the file I have shared.
Dear participants, this data set I am sharing your mail, kindly upload this idle ID.
Now, first step is importing the libraries. Step Import these libraries.
Yes, sir. All the libraries are imported.
Imported. Okay. Yes. Then click this arrow.
Yes, sir. All the libraries are imported and tested.
Okay. Now step two. Step 2 is import the IRIS data set. I want to see the data set.
Yes, sir.
Our data is iris underscore df. Now click it. So data set open.
Yes, sir. Data set is open.
Yeah. We have five columns.
Yes, sir.
In our data set, we have five columns. Sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width, and species.
Yes,
all
sir.
Of you got this screen?
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay. Here it is given a row and column, but if not given, then by shape you can no rows and column. So here we have 150 rows and 5 columns.
150 rows and 5 columns. Yes.
Now, first we shall visualize this. We shall first visualize the data by using pair plot. Data equal to underscore df. Then you type as I have typed, sns.pairplot, and we have named the data set at iris underscore df.
Okay, sir. Okay.
U equal to species and palette will set 1. Then click it.
Visualization is displayed, sir.
So set of size is shown by red color, Bharsi color by blue, and Bharsinika by green color. All of you got it or not?
Yes, sir. We got it.
Okay.
The YouTube participants are doing this, but the use and separation is, it is not quoted. This is, sir, this is the plotting style, na, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Okay, sir, okay.
String, the precision set one are string. So you have to use single quotes.
Okay, sir, okay.
So if you do not use, then error will come.
Okay.
Now, we shall step forward. We find the variable x and y. We shall define the variables x and y. And we have seen that there are five columns.
Yes, sir, five columns and yeah, 150 rows.
But we consider four columns as x and right side column, the target one as y. Okay?
Okay, okay, sir.
So for x, drop the right side column. Zero is row, okay. So for column,
okay, sir.
We have taken axis equal to one.
Yeah.
By default, axis zero is row. Okay. By default, it will take axis zero.
Okay.
Now, we shall see whether it has dropped or not.
Yes,
now
sir.
Four columns. We need.
Okay.
We have considered these four columns as X. Sepal length, sepal wide, petal length, petal wide. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now, we'll define Y.
Sir, we declare y-axis, no, sir?
X is equal to 1.
Okay, sir.
X is equal to 1, we'll choose column. X is equal to 0, we'll choose row.
Okay.
So, right, X is equal to 1. And by default, it is X is equal to 0, so we have to write it.
Sir, here y replies actually target value.
Yeah. This one. Sona, see the only the right side column has come.
Yes, sir, yes. A species name is in the right side column, sir.
Yeah. That yes, is the target yes. value, Y.
Yes, sir. This is the target value.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Step 4.
Yes.
Now in step 4, split this data set into training set and the test set.
Okay, sir. Set into training
split,
set
split.
And text set. Split set. Okay.
Split the.
Split the data set.
Into training set and test set.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Now, for the code, we have again used. Sklearn dot model selection. From Sklearn dot model underscore selection import. Train and so test under the split. Text train, comma, text test. Y train Y test. So this is equal to by simply typing, it is automatically coming. Train test is split. We are splitting X and Y. So write X comma Y. and we shall split into 70-30. Okay.
Yes, sir.
70% for training and 30% for testing. So you have to write the test size. And it randomly chooses. So also random state. X train comma X test, Y train comma Y test equal to train test split and inside bracket X comma Y, because we are splitting X and Y. And test size is 0.3, I mean 30%, 70-30.
Yes, sir, 70-30, sir.
Yeah, 70-30, so we simply write a test size 0.3. And random is set to, okay.
Okay.
Now training the model.
Yes, sir. Train the model, sir. Training model.
Yes, GST, support vector classifier.
Okay. It is automatically coming, sir. SCP?
No, no, step I am writing. Then
okay,
it will
okay,
automatically
okay.
come. Training the SVC model. First, we have to train the data, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Again, we have to import from Scalar.
Scalar
dot SBM
dot SBM.
Sir, so Scalar is having all the is the package
yeah.
algorithm, I think so.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Scalar we using everything for training the data and TensorFlow also we use Scalar.
Here we have not used C. If
yes,
you want
sir.
To use C, then in the inside this bracket you use.
Okay.
Okay. Otherwise okay. it will take as one, C equal to one. Thank you. the format showing. Advantage of this system is it shows the format.
Yes, sir.
We have named X train and Y train. Now, check the accuracy of our model.
Yes, sir.
Dot score will give you like is. We have to tell.
Yes, sir.
Check the accuracy using X test and Y test.
Yeah, yes, sir.
So it comes out to 97.
Accuracy is 0.97.
Yeah.
Sir, can you if the 9.77 accuracy is coming? We increase this accuracy
by changing the test size and random state.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir. I am proceeding, but time you check it.
Okay, sir.
It may increase.
Okay, sir.
But it is also good. By using deep learning, it will be 99%. Now we shall use the confusion matrix. From scalar dot matrix import. Prediction we haven't done. Okay, sir.
Here
it will compare.
Yes, sir.
So here after this 97.7%.
Yes.
Prediction. Thank you.
prediction?
Prediction equal to a SVC model. Okay, now we shall see the prediction.
Okay, sir.
See, for X test, these are the...
Yes, sir. This the vector information is coming, sir.
In from the
inform of the arrays.
We have taken 30% as X test for the, these are the output.
Okay, sir.
We had already earlier trained. Okay. Next step. Step 6. This will compare Y test and the prediction.
Okay, sir. Like this.
And prediction.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
See. The diagonal element are the
70, 14 and 13 is coming.
Yeah, correctly predicted.
Okay,
and
okay.
One, this is one is misclassified. And
yes,
total,
sir, yes.
total how much?
Total 150 returns, sir.
30% of 150.
Yes, sir, 30% of 150. Okay, sir, okay, sir.
Add it. 45. Out of 45, only one is misclassified. So,
yeah, yes, sir.
What is the error? 97.7.
Yes, sir, 97 points.
Now, we shall plot confusion matrix. Thank you. see, this is the confusion matrix plotted.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now.
Only the one, what is the different color, no, sir?
Yeah, misclassified.
Yes,
that is the error.
Misclassified.
Yes, that is the error.
Okay, sir.
Next step is step number how much?
7, sir.
So new prediction. We shall do
New prediction.
This was our 3.2, we are making 5.5. And then here you can 6.4.
Sir, 6.4.4, okay, sir.
SVC model dot predict.
Yes, sir.
And this variable name X new.
X new.
Yeah. Now run it. So this comes up to be Virginia.
Okay, sir.
Similarly, if you want, rather than you can change X new and C. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So here, what we have done, first divided into training set and test set.
Okay,
we have taken 70-30, 70% for training set and 30% for test set.
30% for the prediction.
Yeah, and our model name is SVC model,
yes, sir.
Vector classifier. And then we have checked the X test data. And after that, prediction. Okay. In this model, our accuracy of the model is 97.7%. Only one misclassified. Out of 45, 70-30 means,
yes,
45. Yes, is a 45 out of 50, 45. And so only one is misclassified, so error is 97.7%. And this,
yes.
In this way, we have predicted for new value.
The version is
good. Yeah. If you change the data, then you can see, you'll get another value. So,
okay,
we have run it and seen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That mathematical derivation of support vector machine. Not in the slide. So if somebody want to do research work, he may require that. So then ask.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If somebody requires, collect from me and give them. Okay. Otherwise, mathematical requires that. So then ask.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If somebody requires, collect from me and give them. Okay. Otherwise, mathematical derivation is boring. So I have not done that.
Yes, sir.
Because everyone do not require.
Sir, in this case, the 18 number x mu. We change any column.
Yeah, out of four columns, change any column.
Yeah. Yes, sir. That's fine. We change the value and then we predict the confusion.
Yeah, prediction will give you.
Okay. That's fine, sir.
Okay, then I am closing.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sunil, sir, any questions, sir? Sunil, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, this student have doubt.
What doubt?
Okay.
You can ask the question. Are you available?
Dev Sharan?
Hello?
Yes, you call Dev.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir, question on
question.
Sir, actually the question was, if the machine takes the old data and adapts and after interpreting it makes into a new adaptive data, so does the old data gets depleted or does it still remains?
Means you are training with old data?
Yes, sir.
No. If you, depending upon the program you write that you want to delete the old data, it will be deleted.
Oh, okay, sir.
Because you are training with the old data. And now, after getting the result, you want to train with the other.
Yes, sir.
No, but training system, what data it has taken, it has trained according to that.
So, sir, does the input data size is always equal to the output size?
Input data size means, what do you mean, row, column? See, here we have four columns and output was one.
Okay, sir.
Exercise, we have four columns and the target value we have one. Y equal to function of x. Okay, thank you then.
Okay, sir. Thank you, Mehta sir. Sunil sir, any questions, sir? And you also learned this machine learning language. Any experience, if you have any experience, then share with us.
Actually, this is a really good platform, Google Colab. Whatever we are programming here, it is directly going to save in our drive. So we can directly access. Basically, it is in cloud basis. So we can easily access anything about that. Apart from that, as the sir is doing the programming, it is always showing the help, like what next programming we are doing. And apart from that, it is supporting all the data visualization, pre-processing, and all the packages, recent packages like SQLN, TensorFlow, Keras. So it is very effective, I think so.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Dear participant, Sunil Kumar Goda, sir, is a scholar of Dr. Mehta, sir. So Mehta, sir, is doing in machine learning training and Neil sir also expertise on the machine learning, and both are doing very expertise in the machine learning. I also use the Google Colab and KNN, deep learning, all these things I did in my system. Some error is effective. Suppose we train the data and target the single value, and the confusion matrix is coming. The percentage of prediction is conflicting in the different KNN are the different results, ANN are the different results, and this tensor, this vector machines are the different results. So this is the very important things the research scholar do their research and predict the their input value. So once again, I thank to Dr. Ashok Kumar Mehta to given this time and presenting this such type of topic. And thank you once again. Anything more, Shweta Madam? Shweta Madam? Yes, yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir. There is no any issue.
Okay, okay, okay. Thank you, everybody, to joining this FDP. I share all the recordings and all the PPT to all the participants, their respective mail ID. I have the mail ID, and every day we sending the recorded video, and PPT is collecting from the expertise, and then the end of the FTP we circulate all the PPTs. Okay, and certificate issue is there. The certificate will providing within the 14 working days. We calculating the percentage of attendance, percentage of participants, and then we providing one link, and you click on the link and give your certificate automatically in your respective mail ID. So thank you all of you to being here in online FTP very much. Arvind Pandey sir. Yes, sir. Any sir? Hello, Arvind Pandey sir. Sir, your voice is not coming, sir. Hello. Okay, okay, madam. We bind up the session.
Yes, sir. Thank you, participants, and thank you, presenter, for giving your
precious time.
Tomorrow is last session of our OFDP. Thank you, everyone.
Yes, okay. Okay, madam, it is closing. Close it.
Yeah.